So I want to really quickly show you some of the vision, that we are trying to paint with both the investors as well as UNHCR. In fact, I'm meeting with a number of people this week with UNHCR to basically talk about all these things. But if you look at our basic things, right, I think it's really important you also get familiar with this simple vision, right? Which is, we are StepUp.One. We believe access to education and opportunities are a fundamental human right, but 80 million refugees do not have these rights. We can change this by reskilling and employing 1 million refugees in one marketable skill over the next 10 years. Okay, so this is our stated mission now. Each one of them can earn $2,000 per year, which is very, very average, okay? Because we are talking about 1 million people, I have put a an average of $2,000 per year, which means nearly it is around $150 to $200 a month, approximately. I'm sure many, many of you will make much, much more than $2,000 per year, but I've just put an average. If we made an average of this, we should be hitting a $2 billion income for the camp, that is, say, Kakuma or Kiziba, and a $10 billion economy for the host community, which is like the Turkana County, right? So this one slide tells the entire vision, objective, outcome, and who's going to benefit out of it. Is this, I mean, this is like my first starting slide. I know it may be not what you wanted to see or hear first thing in the morning today, but if you have any comments, do please let me know. I'll just pause for one second because it's such an important slide. And do you guys have anything to tell me?
Nothing so far, Anis.
Okay, cool. Okay, excellent. Let me just quickly, go to the next one. I'm going to just show you a few things, right? So these are not important. We've already seen some of these things. You guys keep sharing it. I've added this new slide, which is our self-service onboarding system for new graduates has helped us scale from 50 to 250 in less than 6 months. So I've just put a screenshot of this thing because many people do not know how we are doing this. So I've just put this as a thing. These slides, you guys know. These also, I've just changed the titles, so that it's a bit more explanatory. All these things. I have also come up with this new thing, actually. I don't know whether you guys have seen this, but basically, I'm trying to differentiate what is social selling, okay, the one-to-one personalized conversation, what is marketing, one-to-N public facing. And then if you look at this, right, I have started putting, new thing called research and data gathering. Yesterday something amazing happened, right? So yesterday there was a client meeting and we were pitching social selling to them because this is what we do really good. Then they said no. Then we started telling social marketing. They said no. Then they said we want this. Just a few days ago, we didn't have all these things. We didn't have research and data gathering as a part of our service. We didn't have validation and list building as a part of our service. Okay, we had translation, but yesterday we won a $300 job for doing research and data gathering. It's so simple. In fact, I think this is simple than the other two things. But because it is not a repetitive task, it is a little bit more this thing, we are keeping the price a little bit higher for this, research and data gathering. So all these things are at $300 a month, right? You guys know that. I mean, I don't have to tell you. You know all these things. I'm just repeating it. Then I talked about, who's my potential client and where they are. So there are 7 million people in large companies, 6 million clients in medium companies, and 25 million clients in small companies. And what is a large company? Any company that is more than 10,000 people. What is a medium company? 1,000 to 10,000 people. What is a small company? Anyone between 1 person to 200 people company, I'm calling it as small company. Is this clear where our 38 million potential clients are there? So from this 38 million people, we just need to win 1 million of them. So we have 38 times more people. I'm sure you guys know this, that everyone is willing to try. We know this. You guys know all these things. I don't want to, talk about all these things. These are just for investors. What we have done so far, what can you do from now? So, this is a small change I'm going to make, when we share the slide, we do not want it to be like, become our client. We want to give our client an option. You can either become our client, or you can give us your voice so that we can be here, like join us as a mentor, or you can be like Hootsuite or Canva or one of these clients, so you can partner with us, right? So these are the three options that you can do from now. So I wanted to make sure that we give them. So just a quick digression. I didn't want to spend too much time, but this will be our new, pitch deck that we will be sharing with every single one of our potential clients as a part of the second message. I've already shared the second message, but I'll do it officially today. Any thoughts or questions on this deck? It's pretty simple. I don't think any major changes, but this will be the new deck that we will be sharing with all our potential clients from now onwards. Okay, all right. Now let's just ask the question, if you have anything to add or ask, just quickly. So how do we do the leaderboard? I will just quickly explain this. So today, as of today, we have 84,581 clients in this database or in this system, in HubSpot. Can you imagine how small this is compared to 38 million people that we are chasing? Just to give you a sense of scale, right? We at some point in time, you should see the number 38 million here. I don't know whether you can even imagine this. I can't imagine that. It looks too big and too, let me just make the screen big. Can you see this number? 84,581 records. So our ambition at some point in time is to make this 84,038 million, and out of this 84,000 today, as of today, what we have done is, if I choose, just quickly, let me choose how many people you have contacted. The way I'll choose that is, I'll click on lead status. I will select the number of people you have contacted, 47,922. Number of people connected back, 50,683. And people who have also been contacted on email. I think we have not contacted anybody on email because it's the same thing. So then I know it is 50,000. So we have 84,000 people. 50,000 has been contacted, which means 30,000 are still yet to be contacted. Okay. And I'm keep on updating these records. I'm just explaining this to everybody so that everybody is on the same page, right? Then what I do, I export all these 50,000 into an Excel sheet so that, we can do some, easy graphs. So this is where it is. This is all the people that I've exported. I've exported every one of them. If you see 54,000, something will be there on the bottom. Yeah. Can you see this? 54,000 people. Yeah. And then I do a small graph to see who's leading from the front. Yeah, so this is the leaderboard. Muhammad Abdul Qadir is leading with 3,000 connections so far. Shem is 1953. Burberry, 1,711. Ahmed Ali, 1,704. Mohaiddin is 1,605. Patience, Selimani, Ezra, Donut, Kasi, Sheila, everybody is closing in. Martha, all of the people, Isra, everybody is here. So this is how the leaderboard is looking like right now. Again, I'm extremely, extremely happy with this leaderboard. 50,610, which is incredible, you know, which is incredible. But so which means, you know, our social selling engine is on fire. It's really doing very well. My only feedback is that the people at the bottom of this list, you have to really wake up. You have to really, you know, start doing. I think even the one in the middle, please don't lose hope. This is the only way, you know, you can get your second job. I know many of you in the middle already have your first job or even your second job. So you think, why should I really, you know, do this work? Yeah. Why should, you know, all these people here, right? All of you have one job at least. So you think, you know, why should we do this? Why should we keep sending messages to potential clients? We already have one job. We are already having, you know, good, you know, money. But remember, you can do up to three jobs. And then when you get the fourth job, you can create your own team. That's the game, right? So I really, really, you know, even if you have one job or even if you have two jobs, please do not, so, you know, stop working for yourself. I know you're working for a client, but, you know, please work for yourself as well. That's what you do when you start sending these things, right? So, and then coming to the bottom and also to all the leaders, please, you know, start increasing your effort, because I know many of the leaders are managing more than 10, 20 people. So it is very hard for you yourself to do, you know, the thing. But if you don't do this amongst all these 100 or so people, the group leaders and the team leaders, you have the best credibility. And because you have the credibility, it is important that your LinkedIn accounts are being used to the fullest possible extent. I don't even mind if you are really busy, then share your LinkedIn with your team and ask them to, you know, do the job on behalf of you. Because remember, if you get a job, you anyway are not going to do it. You have to give it to your, you know, teams. So make use of your LinkedIn, you know, like for example, Zach, you know, ED. What happened to ED? Why is ED on the bottom? There is two EDs, is it? Okay. So, you know, all of you, like, you know, Priscilla, Muhammad Abdul Qadir, I think, you know, John Baptiste, you know, Kaposo. I mean, you guys have to really, you know, increase the effort so that, you know, you can catch up. Yeah, I mean, this is my sincere request. Please don't, you know, please don't disregard it. It is really important that, you know, even the leaders who already have one or two or three jobs, you know, use their LinkedIn, because your LinkedIn is the most powerful LinkedIn. You know, John Bosco and John Baptiste, I think it's really important that you put your LinkedIn to use. You know, I know you have too much to do, but don't forget, you know, you have to work for yourself also. You know, it's really important. Okay, so that's the quick overview of the leaderboard today. I don't know how to stress the importance of, you know, leaders coming to the rescue. The reason why you're all as leaders is because you have a certain credibility, you have a, you know, amazing connectivity with so many things. So please use that. Use that to your advantage. You cannot be you know, taking it easy just because you have jobs or your team. You know, you need to find jobs for your teams. It's really important. Yeah. So that's about the leaderboard. Any questions on the leaderboard? Any, like, still are you, is there anybody here whose name is not there in the leaderboard? And, you know, they don't know why they are not in the leaderboard. No, it's all fine. Cool. All right, let's go back to last week actions. What we said we are, so if you look at last week, our social selling is going amazingly well. We moved from 30,000 to 40,000 this week, which means nearly 10,000 just in the last 7 days, right? Now, guess how much we are today? We are 50,000, which means we have added another 10,000 this week alone, which is amazing actually, without a lot of you participating. Yeah. So we should have more people participating, right? So a lot of you who are in this call today are really not doing the thing. I don't want to call names and make it really difficult, but you know who you are. I know who you are. So please start doing, more social selling. You know, that's the single biggest thing that you can do. Second thing that we looked at is our social media marketing is quite bad. Despite spending 1 hour last week, 1 hour before last week, and I don't know what to do to fix this. I've tried my best and none of you want to really help in the social media thing. I want to again call Festin, Yahya, John Bosco, and a few more people who are there in the social media team. Please kickstart this engine. This engine is like the jackpot. I don't know whether you know the word jackpot, right? So social selling, right? It's a small increment. Every week we are incrementing by 10,000 more people, right? You know, that's what social selling does. But one good post, we don't know which one is that, but one good post can reach a million people. Is Paul here on this call? Paul or Christian, you're there. I mean, you guys know about this thing, what I'm saying, right? Bahana, you should know about what I'm saying. You know, Bahana just posted about an entrepreneur, and in like within a few days, it reached 3,000 people, just one post. So it's important that we don't ignore this engine. Our social selling engine is doing very well. Our social media marketing is doing very bad. Is there anybody in this call today who can take a leadership role and fix the social media marketing engine? Looks like Kasi wants to take the lead. He's like coming on camera and saying, I'm going to do this. Is there anybody who can fix this engine? I mean, social selling also needs somebody to, make it really more better, especially the leaders have to be, given a little bit of a injection. But I think in selling is doing very well. I don't know whether it is the competition that has made this happen. I don't know what has really happened, but how do we make marketing also do well? Is there anybody here in this meeting who can take the leadership on making social media marketing engine do well? Come on, guys. There are 41 people in this call. I'm sure there is somebody who's like wanting to do this. Nobody? Okay. I'll just wait until one of you decide. Why, or you can just tell me why it is hard, or no, why it is not an easy thing to fix, and that's why you don't want to take it.
Hello, Mr. Anas.
Yes, Mr. Abdul Qadir.
Yes, I think if you are becoming social media, if you want to post, you just need to edit and to post things only. What other skills do we need from the person to be that position?
I mean, I don't know actually, Abdul Qadir. You know, do you post on your Facebook?
Yes, yes.
It's the same thing, you know. I mean, I don't see why this needs to be any different, you know. Instead of posting for yourself, you're going to be posting for an organization. That's the only difference. It's really nothing, you know, it's the same. Everything is the same. You have to come up with a picture or a good video or a good picture, a good set of, a good, you know, like, what do you say? Like a couple of sentences, and then a bunch of hashtags. You know, it's the same thing. You know, you must be posting every day, or, you know, not every day, maybe every week. Like I posted something just today morning. I mean, just easy. I mean, it's really the difficult part is like how to make your post so good that it becomes viral.
Okay. I think I can do it that if that's the case. I can make and arrange a very attractive post.
Yeah, I mean, like, you know, let me, you don't have to be, I mean, rocket scientist, you know. Just imagine, you know, guys, you know what you're telling me, you know, all the 41 of you here, you know what you're telling me. If you get a social media marketing job today, you're going to struggle to do the job. Is that right, Vahana? All of you are going to struggle to do a social media marketing job for a client. That's the essence of what I'm finding out. Yes, Bahana.
That's not true, Anis. I don't agree with you, Joel. Actually, the reason why I'm not agreeing with you is only because at some point let me say that to me personally, I just kept quiet, not because I can't do it, but I think it's also important to give other people, you know, a place to be part of, you know, what we are doing. Because it's not really good to always be, Joel is doing this, Bahana is doing this, and then what about the rest of the team? That's what I have personally. I'm not talking on behalf of other people, but that's what I felt.
Joel, tell me, you know, social selling, in my view, is repetitive. It's hard, needs a discipline, needs, you know, persistent everyday effort, correct? Social selling.
Of course, Anis. And then when someone is saying, I'm taking responsibility to do this, there is kind of, you know, engagement, your time, you have to document yourself, you have to look for article relevance, you know, the stuff. Yeah.
No, Joel, I fully agree with your point. I really wasn't, you know, debating why you can't do it. I'm trying to understand social selling is hard, but we are doing it very well. We are doing the hard job very well. In fact, exceedingly well. But the easy job of finding a good post or creating a good post is actually not that difficult, you know. 5 minutes, maximum 5 minutes is all you require to create a good post.
I think, can I just suggest something, Anis?
Yes, yes.
I think personally, we don't have to, that's my suggestion. We can come up with a team saying, like, for example, we have 5 people, Joel, Abdulkadir, Bahana, who are focusing on social media selling for Step Up. You understand? Or social media marketing for Step Up. So that it doesn't have like someone feeling like it's a hard work or, you know, challenging at some point. If that person can't do it, like availability, time and other stuff, there is someone to support and come up with the content make everyone active in everything we are doing. That's my only suggestion.
That suggestion is well taken. And we have already created the team, Joel. There is a team and that team is already Yahya, Westin, Sudhi. There is a team of 5 people in that team already.
But do we have a leadership? You know, I mean, who is leading the team?
Yes.
Because
yes.
The team might be there.
Exactly.
But there's no follow up. There must be somebody who is accountable, you know, responsible for making sure that this team is doing the right work. You know, for example, let's say if we agree that One post should be going live every Wednesday, you know, Friday, Saturday. At least we have a point of contact, somebody we can ask what's happening. There's no post that went out, and then that person easily follow up with the colleagues, you know, yes, in the team. And yeah, I think that's just what I want to, you know.
Do you have
such leadership? Yes.
Yes, I absolutely want that. Exactly, that is what I wanted. So I'm going to add Abdul Qadir and Kaposo also into the team. But I really need another leader, and I don't want you or Joel to do any leading business here, because it will definitely impact the other things that you are doing. So I don't want. I really need a leader who can lead this team. That this team is really good. Yahya is doing a phenomenal job. Westin is doing a job every single day. So they are doing something, but we need a leader who can lead this team.
Anis, can I just add something since we are also looking for a leader? Just to add, sorry. I was thinking a leader is just not there to make sure, okay, probably things are working in the group, but also he one of the responsibilities to report back to the entire group. Not just to you, Anis, but since we have a weekly meeting, he has to tell us this week things went like this. Like there is a flow, not just for Anis to monopolize, you know, the meeting. At least the leader can report on what they have been working on.
That's a great
idea.
Since
we are looking for that leader, he has also to think about the report to present at least after 2 weeks on what they have been doing, at least.
Yeah, I think it's really easy, this one, what I'm saying. Yeah. I mean, in fact, I think one such leader is needed for selling also. I think I will go with either Keisha or Shem for social selling leadership, because they already have access to the system from where this report has to be generated. And we can easily ask one of them to be the social selling engine leader. Because everything that I'm doing, right, I'm generating. So I'm going to this contacts, creating the lead status, exporting the, exporting the table, then creating this thing. I'm just doing it in the last 5 minutes or 10 minutes before we start the meeting so that I get the leaderboard. So if somebody can do this, it becomes really obvious. It's a very simple thing, you know. What did you do? You know, a little bit more I want to do. Like, for example, you know, if you look at contact owner, I also want to do the lead status here, actually, so that, you know, if you look at this now, suddenly, I can put like this also, right? Like this columns, yeah. So if you put like this, I hope you guys can see, it's a small screen, so I don't know whether you can see this properly. So if you look at Shem has connected with 1953 people, of which 120 connected back with Shem. Right? This looks really good number, but I don't know. I want to check this number of Mohaideen Abdul Qadir. Patience is not updating the number of people who are connected back on LinkedIn. Celemony is also not updating. This is actually wrong. Ahmed Abdul Qadir Muhammad is doing something wrong. So you can actually distinguish. So this is an easy report that somebody can publish every week. Maybe Shem or Keisha, one of them will decide, and you know, we can do that. Similarly, you know, if we can have a leader for, you know, social media marketing, that will be good. Can somebody volunteer, or should I call out a name and finish the job like I did for the leader for the social selling engine is still nobody is volunteering. Okay, then who's this?
No, I wanted to volunteer, but I mean, if you have someone else in mind, I think that's.
Mohammed, yes, absolutely. You know, it's a pleasure for you to, you know, do this, Mohammed Hassan. It's not really hard work, actually, you know. And Mohammed, you have a phenomenal team. These guys are really good. You got obviously these two guys, but there is, you know, more guys like Westin is there, Yahya is there. There is a few more people who are there. And honestly, you know, even if you did just, I don't know, maybe how many posts you think we should do in a week? Like every week we meet, how many posts do you think we should do every week?
I think we should aim for realistically about 3 posts.
About 3?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I think 3 is very good. Very good number. Very easy and simple. Yeah. So yeah, we can do that. Where did it go here? It should be here. Okay, got it. So what's the date today? 24th of July. Okay, cool. Okay, so 3 posts week. Okay. And who should we appoint? Anybody has any views on who we should appoint for leader for social media selling engine? You see, that selling engine, actually, honestly, there is nothing big you need to do. You just need to do one report, that's all, and tell everybody who's the leaderboard, who's leading. That's it. Okay, since we are not getting anybody, I will appoint, Shem John to do this job. We'll report every week on where we stand. And let's say, Shem, it is your duty to change this 10K to maybe 12K a week. So that's your target. So we are currently doing around 10,000 people a week. You know, you need to increase that to 12,000 a week, which is very easy, actually. You just need to make Bahana and Joel, you know, do a little bit more work. That's all. All right.
Mr. Nils.
Or if you work a little harder, Shem, you yourself can do this, actually, because you seem to be working, you know, really well. Yes, Mohammed, please go ahead.
Yeah, I have a quick question. For the marketing, so just briefly, I mean, are we going to be posting or on our individual accounts, or we're posting on behalf of Step Up?
Okay. Yeah. No, it is all going to be on behalf of Step Up. Okay, so let me just show you. So you know what you will be given, or Mohammed. We will give you access. So just now, I'll just see if I can give you access. So you see this, right? So this is the Step Up LinkedIn post. So manage the admins. So these are all the people who are currently, you know, able to administer, you know, the Step Up post, you know, this list. Okay. So I'm going to add you.
And we're posting on topics ranging from human rights, displacement, productivity, all of that, education.
No, Muhammad, you know, just like go crazy, you know, just go crazy, because, you know,
Muhammad, what we need is original content.
Yeah, ideally. Ideally original content, but don't go mad on that. I mean, you know, if you can do even 1 or 2 original content, it's okay. You can share other people's original content, which is really good, with a small comment.
Oh, okay.
Okay, because that's really easy. You know, sharing someone else's content with just a, you know, especially the Olympics is on. I'm sure there's a lot of, you know, refugee content is coming. So you can just share.
Yeah, definitely. Mohammed, not Mohammed Hassan for the name. It's Mohammed Mahmoud.
Okay. Like,
Mohammed.
I'll find it, Mohammed. Don't worry. I think, you know, this is like, you know, you don't have to anyway do anything here. Okay. All you have to do is, you know, come into Hootsuite, because, you know, that's the easy thing. You don't have to come here, do anything here. You know, we'll make sure that, you know, your account is active here. You come here, you click on post, which is like, you know, this one, then you select the entire list basically, which is, you know, Step Up has one list. So if you click this and come down, there is something called Step Up One Team. So you click this, it will select every single StepUp.one, you know, thing. So you don't have to like post, go to every one of them and post. All five are here. Then you basically say, what an amazing start for the Tokyo Olympics for the refugee team, whatever, right? Blah, 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 right? And then
you
after that,
maybe you can say something like running for safety, running for gold or something.
Sorry, running for safety. Yeah.
To running for gold now. What an amazing transition.
Running for gold. Yeah, let's do this. Let's post this right now. So running for safety to running for gold.
Or you can ask even just imagine, mm-hmm. you know, running from running for safety for your own safety, and then imagine running for your own safety to running for gold now.
Imagine.
What an amazing transformation.
No, I like this one. You know, it's really good. I think as a tagline, this is amazing. Running for safety to running for gold. Then you say something. Then you can say a few just imagine, just see a sentence and let me find, you know, a refugee Olympic team. You know, I click refugee Olympic team. Just Muhammad, you know, keep thinking of a nice, slogan, nice, word, nice sentence to complete that slogan that you just created. I'm just going to look for a nice, shall we go with this picture or this picture? Which one is nice? This one or this one?
I think you have to have one with the, maybe the UN logo visible so people can understand the refugees.
There is this, Time Olympic.
Yeah. And you think we should tag the athletes?
Or this?
Make sure you, I think it will also be good to use the, this year's photos, because I can see a bunch of these ones for last Olympics for the Brazil.
Okay, guys, you have to answer my question. Is this yeah. is good? Or this is not good. I think we'll go with something where, you know, they can see the, this one, Team Olympia, this is good actually. Because it shows the this one, the you know, Team Olympic or D Refugee. Shall we go with this picture?
Yeah.
Because, you know, it is, so all you have to do is, you know, copy image. I think you can just copy image by right click and, I think you can paste it. I'm not entirely sure. No, it's not working. So it's drag and drop. So I can drag from the screen.
I think if we just take our time now, Anas, this is from Brazil. I think we can
this
find
is
one.
Brazil.
For... Oh, is it?
Yeah, that's
yeah, we need to find one for Tokyo.
Oh, shit. Okay. Oh, no.
So
oh, Tokyo, this is Brazil, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, man. Oh, it should have been really bad, actually. But...
I'm looking now. You can put in Tokyo refugee team, and then you can look at some of the images.
Yeah, this is not right actually, because you know how is Google giving me an old one like this?
I think now. I mean, if you I found one of them. You can look now. If you write the Olympic refugee Tokyo.
Yeah, this is Tokyo, boss. This is Tokyo. No.
Really.
No, because it says Tokyo Olympics, but it doesn't look like Tokyo to me. No, what about this one? No,
there is one with someone who's Chinese with them and from the Tokyo.
Okay, no, this is maybe, yeah, this is
Tokyo. That's Tokyo.
This is Tokyo, right? Yeah,
yeah, that's Tokyo. Yeah, yeah,
that's Tokyo. Yeah, this is Tokyo. But this picture is not even looking good, actually. But anyway, I don't want to really, so I just save this image somewhere. I go back to the something is not right. Save image. Oh, this image is not even saving. Some problem with that image, guys. I'm sorry. Let's do this. I don't want to rush and then, you know, is this, no, this is not the. How about this one? But this is again not the Tokyo. Why this is? I think this is good, guys. What do you think? I don't know. Why nobody else is talking? Is this boring for everybody? Yeah, it can't be this. This girl picture with thousands of people behind. There was nobody in the audience, right? So this is not Tokyo. This can't be Tokyo. So wherever this white shirt girl is there, that cannot be Tokyo. I think this possibly is. Maybe this. Yes, this one. That's it. This one. Yes, this one. Yes, cool.
Yes, that's Tokyo.
That's Tokyo. Oh my God. I can't. This is amazing, man. Just one. You can't find one photo. So you have written running for safety to running for gold, right? So click on this, select the file.
Go no, to... you said from, I think you said from running for safety to running for gold.
Okay. So from. Okay.
Yeah, from running for safety.
Yeah. So from running
for safety.
From running for safety to running for gold, okay? Should we just say running, or you know, should we also say swimming and cycling, or just leave it running for gold?
No,
just joking. You should just leave it like this. You know, now ideally, I think, you know, sometimes I don't like to add hashtags, but it is always good to add some hashtags, right? So at refugees. Right.
Maybe you can add one sentence like, you know, redefining, you know, possibilities, or maybe, you know, maybe breaking the ceiling, you know. Or...
You know, Muhammad, use that. You know, everything you're saying is really good. Please use it for another post. I really think, you know, this alone is amazing. Just from running for safety to running for gold is perfect. Let's leave it at that. I want to just add a few hashtags, refugees, maybe hashtag refugees, hashtag Tokyo 2020.
Even to make it more powerful, Anis, you can drop the from, just saying running for safety to running for gold.
Yeah, I think so. I think, yeah, you can just drop the from. Hashtag refugees, hashtag Tokyo 2020. What else can we say? Hashtag.
Hashtag limitless.
Hi, Anis.
Yes.
I got this idea about getting hashtags. You go on YouTube, not YouTube, Twitter, and then I think you've heard of TweetDecker.
Uh-huh.
When you open, like, you log in on your Twitter, then you go on another tab, open TweetDeck, you will get, there is a last part where the hashtags which are trending, you can copy those hashtags, and they're very important.
Oh, very, very good, yeah. So you're saying, you know, go to TweetDeck, is it?
Yes, now that you're already logged in on your Twitter, you can go TweetDeck. It will just go automatic.
Okay, I'm going to TweetDeck, log in. Oh, God.
Anish?
Yes.
Can you use these hashtags that are being used, that are used like Team Refugees, Tokyo Olympics?
Oh, you already got it? Okay, just give me 1 second. Hashtag Team
Refugees.
Okay.
Tokyo Olympics.
Tokyo Olympics. Anything else? Hashtag. I want to be as less as possible. I don't want like 100 hashtags, you know, for this one. I think 3 itself is good. Hashtag refugees, hashtag Tokyo 2020, hashtag. Okay. I think this is good. Shall we keep it? That's it.
But maybe just include, like, say, maybe congratulations or you make us proud. Just, I think, something. One.
You know, don't, you know, again, you know, Muhammad, I feel less is more.
Okay.
Less is more. You can always do, you know, you make us proud, you know, with one more thing. You know, just go crazy with this Olympics, you know, campaign.
Okay.
Right? But I feel this is perfect, actually. Tokyo team refugees, Tokyo Olympics. Yeah, that's it. And then whenever somebody is winning or, you know, this thing. Okay. So all you have to do, Muhammad, is come in, type these 2 sentences, you know, select that thing, you know, upload. You know, I just selected the file to upload and I did it, right? Because I found the thing here. I right-clicked, I saved the image. I right-clicked here and I uploaded the image. The image is here. Just one time you check here, how is it going to post in everything? So it is post like this in Facebook group, in Facebook page, in Instagram, it's going to post like this. In LinkedIn, it's going to post like this. In Twitter, it is going to post like this. Okay, so you are happy with everything. Okay, all you have to do is come here and say post now. I don't mind, you know, you scheduling it and all those things. But if you have got like 5 things to post, don't put everything post now. Just schedule for later. Right. But this one, we're going to just do post now. Okay. But let me also show you how to do scheduling. It's easy. See, Olympic related stuff, it's important to just post it really quickly. Right. Or you can even, you know, turn auto schedule on so that you don't have to worry about, you know, that's it. You just click schedule. It will automatically say schedule every day, 1 post per day, 10 a.m. and 5 p.m. So, you know, that's it. So I'll click the auto schedule on, you know, if you want, you can do it. You know, I'm not going to do it because I'm going to post right now everything. Oh God, what has happened? Okay, so I'm going to post now. So yeah, it is posted. Let me come back to, you know.
Hello?
Yes, Mana, go ahead.
Yeah, I've also shared in the WhatsApp group a link to a video of Poor Biel, one of the athletes. So he has just made a great video. Maybe we could also add a comment on that.
What did he do?
I mean,
okay, let the games begin, is it? Okay, he said something. Yeah, so this is already there. So you don't have to do anything. All you have to do is, you know, just retweet with a comment or something like that, right? So you just click and then what has happened to my Twitter? I don't know. I hope they're not blocked it. Okay, I think we know what to do, right? I think, you know, let's not, you know, it's already... Okay, there is a problem with permissions on this account. Confirm that you have full admin for one thing. So it has some problem with this Facebook group. Okay, just remove this. I don't think, you know, we need to worry about that Facebook group. Right? Yeah, that's pretty much it. Let me come back and check if it has done the job. Yeah, job done. Running for safety to running for gold. Hashtag, hashtag, hashtag. First one to react. I'll react. All of you can react as well. Okay, I think this is
really simple. So I think, I mean, that's the process, right? We find this something interesting and then we post and we tweet. We write about that, yeah?
Exactly. You find something interesting. You write about it. Just 1 or 2 lines. Hashtags, 1 or 2 lines, either a picture or a video. It's as simple as that. So this is, look at this, you know. Okay, so this is John Bosco has posted it, right? So he said this, everything. but he has basically taken this and put it here. Can you see? So that's good. So John Bosco is already doing something amazing. This is me posting it, but then, you know, it doesn't matter who's posting it, right? You know, the good news is it's all posted in stepup.one. That's it.
So I mean, I just want to ask one more question, Anas, which is, do we want to have different different content for different outlets, or just it's all the same?
No. It's all the same. All the same. Don't even think all that is needed when we have become like, you know, like $1 billion something. Right now, it's the same thing for everything. So which is why I showed you, you know, the Hootsuite thing, right? You log into Hootsuite, you know, which is like this, and then you post the same thing in all of the things, like, you know, in one click. You just click once, it gets posted everywhere without any you know, problems.
So let's say for example, you want to write Monday motivations, and you just want to write maybe 200 or 300 words. So you're still going to post on Twitter. That is something suitable for LinkedIn, maybe.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah.
No. You always come to Hootsuite. You know, you see here, this is Hootsuite. Then publish, you know, here, create a post, you know, click on create a post. Then select stepup.one here, which is all the accounts of StepUp, right? Then write your text here. Then drag and drop your file here, your image here. That's it. And then you click post. Is that clear, Mohammed?
Yeah, sounds good.
Yeah, because, you know, I don't want, otherwise, you know, you log in into all these five, we have to share the password for all these five. It's too much work, right? Insert, we onboard you here. I think you're already here. Install, you know, manage accounts and teams. Yeah, you're already here. You know, teams, stepup.one team, add a member. Yeah, you're already here. So you're added into this one. You know, we'll see if there is a problem. Let me just, 1 second. View member details. I'll just send a confirmation for you again. I think this one should come to you. If there's a problem, you know, just let me know where it is stuck. I think, yeah, a message should have gone to this Mohammed.Hassan@stepup.one. So just check this email ID. If you don't remember the password, I will send it to you again. But that is the... so this is your email, and I'll also share your password. I think it will be the same. This will be the password. And the mail thing will be there at mail.one.com, I think. Yeah, check it out. All right. So we're done with at least identifying a leader for this. And we will identify, you know, one more leader for our selling engine, which is Shem, who will report every week on where we stand. And let Mohammed Hassan do the marketing. The third engine is onboarding, or the first engine is onboarding. Actually speaking, I think it is working very well. Okay, I mean, it's working very well, meaning, in my opinion, it is working very well. But people told me all these feedback last week, right? They said we should set expectations, right? That nothing will happen in 1 day or 1 week or 1 month. It will take at least 2 or 3 months for you to, you know, get a job. You should be prepared to spend money. You should have internet. You should have computer. If you don't have any of those things, at least watch the videos, which is what I think, Mohammed, you told. So what I've done, I've taken all of these 10 points and then I have put them all into the onboarding email. So from now onwards, the UNHCR guys have agreed to send this onboarding email or onboarding message. Let me just show you. So there is this Jenny here who's trying to do the onboarding thing. So if you look at what we are doing, we are going to be using you know, this link. Okay, so this is again just one link, which will be sent to any new graduate. Okay, I can share this link with all of you as well, so that you can also share this link with, you know, if you want to onboard any new graduate, all you have to do is to share them this link. That's all. So it starts with welcome to StepUp.1. You know, dear graduate, you know, start reading this. First, understand why we started our story. I mean, why did we do this? You know, setting expectations. It takes 2 weeks to learn the skill and 8 weeks to get a job. But this also really depends on how fast you want to do this. You need a laptop. You need to consistently work for at least 1 hour every day. You need to also join us every Saturday. Here, this is the one group for discussing doubt and one group for, you know, receiving your instructions. Once you have joined, please send us all these information. We have also designed the system, which is basically our next system, right? Which is our onboarding system. And then if this system is difficult, then click here. You will explain, you know, how to follow the system, right? Which is, you know, again, over here. And then many thanks. You can put your name below as a signature. So this is the onboarding, you know, link that every one of you can share with other people, to basically, you know, share. I don't know whether Niall is there in this call. Last week, you know, he onboarded a bunch of people and I just gave him, you know, this exact same email so that he can onboard all his new people. So any questions on this onboarding engine, any comments, questions? On this onboarding thing, guys. I mean, I don't know whether we need a leader for this onboarding engine, but if we need a leader, then I will appoint Mr. Keisha for this leader for onboarding engine, right? Basically, it's the engine that is going to keep on onboarding hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people, you know, every month, every week, you know, as we grow, right? So we've got these three things sorted out. Now, reskilling engine, I think, is what we want to discuss today, right? And also the finding jobs. Okay. Let me just, you know, let's do this reskilling engine first, right? So what is this reskilling engine, right? There are two levels of reskilling, okay? Can somebody tell me what are these two levels? If, let's say you are getting started today, if I told you, you know, which is what I was telling before, if I gave you 100 videos and ask you to go and do all the 100 videos and come back, will you come back? Each video is like, let's say 1 hour. Right? So there are two levels, reskilling to a level where you can get started with a job. Right? I don't know, many of you may or may not agree to this, but I think, you know, there is only two lessons needed, right? To get started on work. And the second one is mastering the skill so that you can do all the services and have team members with you. I think this is the, you know, thing. This might need 20 lessons, right? And the way I'm trying to do this, guys, is this okay? Or do you think we need to split it into many more reskilling? I mean, we have to split it, obviously. So, you know, one is social selling, one is social marketing, media marketing. And the third one, instead of services, I'm going to call this social media research. So that, you know, we are same, you know, it's like social selling, marketing, and research. And then we have to master all these three skills. Okay, first, we are, you know, learning those skills. Then we have to master these skills, isn't it? Is this two levels good enough for the reskilling engine? Or we need more levels? Any thoughts? Okay, I'll keep those levels here so that, you know, we'll come back to that later. Okay, so where are we doing this reskilling, right, guys? You know, we are doing it, you know, under the same thing, right? For example, this one, we are doing it here. You know, we start, I mean, we've got the step-by-step instructions, but, you know, they are not really reskilling. The reskilling starts in step number 18 and step number 19, where we have a 90-minute lesson on social selling and another 90-minute lesson on social marketing. So these are the two lessons that you need in order to get reskilled on, you know, reskilled just enough so that you can start your first job without really needing anything more. Yeah. So our reskilling engine is not some separate engine that is lying down somewhere. It starts with these two steps, step 18 and 19, right? But honestly, I don't think you guys need to worry about these two steps. I'm assuming most of you or all of you have already gone through this. You already know some of these things, right? Which is, you know, which is why you are doing all these steps from 20 to, you know, 26, right? But where you need to really, you know, master it starts, you know, here. When you start working for a client, obviously going through these steps will, you know, strengthen your you know, your skills, number one. But if you want to master, then you have to come here. Okay, so if you see, I have not even added the first step inside mastering the social selling, which is number 6. I hope you guys are able to follow this thing, whatever I'm saying. You know, can somebody just tell me whether it's all this is clear? Yeah, can you see these guys, you know, getting started, learning skills, finding your first job, working on social selling, working on social media marketing, and then comes number 6, mastering social selling, and number 7, mastering social media marketing. So 6 and 7, which is the essence of the reskilling engine, we have the content, but I have not yet, you know, made them into a proper engine so that, you know, we know which one to do first, second, third. But this is what will be our, you know, the important one for, you know, developing a reskilling engine. Any questions or thoughts about this? Do you think this way you can learn? Because, you know, if you look at the way I'm teaching here, right, this is not a typical teaching mechanism. If you go to any course, it will have like chapters, titles, videos, right? That's normally how they don't do, like, do this step one, you know, read that step two. It's not step by, I mean, even though that is also steps, this is like more rigorous steps, you know, every little detail is added here. So I don't know whether you like this way of doing it, but this way of doing, you know, we cannot let you make any mistake, right? So I believe this is will be built out. Mastering social selling will be built out. Mastering social media marketing will be built out. We already have the content, but we need to build it. You know, having content is not good enough. It took me a long time to build the first 5, which is already there, right? So I'll do this, but I just wanted to pause and ask you whether this way of teaching, which is, you know, learning by doing, is it really helping, especially the new people, because it'll be very useful to get your thing. And the second question I have is, you know, can somebody, you know, also, you know, want to maybe join hands with me to create these steps? So that we 2 or 3, we can have a small team of people to create this, you know, reskilling engine. So these are the 2 questions I had. So who's going to, can somebody give me some answer? Like maybe Kaposho or John. What do you guys think about this reskilling engine? You know, is this something useful? What happened, guys? Why nobody? Everybody is very quiet. Sorry, Kaposa, did you say something? I couldn't really.
Yeah, I'm asking the question. I didn't get well.
Oh, you're asking what is the question, huh?
Yeah.
No, see, you know, this reskilling engine, what we are calling as a reskilling engine is nothing but these steps, you know. Is this something that is working for you in terms of learning ideas, learning how to do things by going through each step and doing that step? Is this way of reskilling, is it really working for you?
Yeah, sure. Because even it helps a lot. Instead of asking anyone every time, it is good to pass through all of the steps. And then wherever you have a problem, it's where you will ask, instead of asking everything. You know, even this is the way which makes many people to come up with the step up skills, whereby whoever asking you, how did you get to step up, you normally share with him the link of a click up. Normally pass through those steps, and he understands better than if he could ask you on WhatsApp, and sending him audios will not help. It will not be helpful than reading himself and following those videos. So I think this is useful for me.
Absolutely, I agree with you, Kaposo. Yeah. So you know, just to show you, maybe you know, I don't know whether some old people can also comment, right? Maybe you know, this is how we had our originally, right? You know, our content was like this. You guys remember? I don't know whether you guys went through some of these things, but it is really hard. If I just send somebody this link, you know, let's say Kaposo itself, right? If I send him this link, he comes here and then he's like really confused. No, okay, should I click on this first? Okay, then what happens? Scenario one, then I start the course and then I come to, you know, something, but it's really hard for me to like, okay, what should I do after this? You know, what should I do after this? Is it right way? It's not easy. It is not holding your hand and walking with you one step at a time. You understand this? So this is how 99% of the world learns whatever you're saying right now. I don't know whether you're able to appreciate the difference between this and this. You guys with me? They are very, very, you know, 100, you know, it's totally different, the two approaches. You know, one is like this and the other is like this, right? And what I'm working on from here, guys, okay, it's still not yet, I know, even ClickUp has not figured out how to do it. What I'm working on, I mean, is this clear, guys? I really want somebody or, you know, a few people to agree with me or disagree with me. Do you see the difference between learning like this, you know, lesson by lesson versus step by step? I mean, it might seem very obvious and, you know, easy and stupid for you, but it's not actually. To come up with this, it took me 3 years of, you know, mind-bending thinking.
Can I say something, Kanish?
Yes, Mahana.
Yes, actually, I think we all need to appreciate, you know, the fact that the step-by-step, you know, approach is very good compared to the previous one, the learning with the videos, because, you know, just like you say, you know, it goes hand in hand with you, you know, from this step to the next step, and you know, like, you know, the flow of doing the work and all these things. But also at the same time, I appreciate, you know, the fact that you thought of it, the mastering the skills itself, because I also felt like we are missing something, because this is good for onboarding, yes. Actually for somebody who are just coming for the first time, yeah. But it's not helping for the existing, like some of us, like we are not advancing, you know, in terms of skills and learning new things and all these things. This is what we have currently is good for onboarding, for, you know, new people coming in, but we don't have, you know, I mean, a mastery, you know, something that, you know, help the existing graduate to level up. I don't know whether you get my point. Yeah, and yeah. That's why I think if you look at the steps, I mean, the steps of executing social media selling, we are still missing some steps in these step-by-step, you know, step-by-step approach.
Yes.
Like, you know, the creating the videos, the Canva stuff, and all these things are not yet in this. So,
I agree. I think, you know, that's what I want to do. The way I'm dividing, and it's a good point. So it's a good point you've made. So I'm going to make this into three parts, actually, not two parts. The first part is reskilling up to a level where you can get started with a job. Yeah. So that's the first level. So we'll call it reskilling 101. Okay. So level reskilling 101 is level where you can level from where you can get started with a job. Okay. Only two lessons. Then we say reskilling 201. Okay. So this is a level from where you can work for a client, right? End to end. Okay. Just one client. Okay. Be it whatever, you know, it can be any of these three. You know, it doesn't have to be just, you know, this one, right? It can be any of these three. So here itself, we will bring most of the things Bahana, which is like, you know, creating videos, creating posts, creating Hootsuite, all those things, okay? So that is the reskilling 101. This is reskilling 3001, like this. You know, 101, 201, 301. This is mastering the skill, actually. Okay. So this is enough to get started. Right? Enough to get started with a job. This is enough to work for a client end to end. Let's call it, you know, maybe 10 lessons, okay? And the third engine, we'll say reskilling 101, which is mastering so that you can do all the services and have team members with you. So this mastering Bahana, we will take social selling, you know, like for each of them, what does mastering selling means, right? You know, what are the things? So for example, can you help me Bahana or anybody, you know, what does, like, for example, you know, what is enough work, like, okay, let's do this, right? So we'll only take social selling. What is a skill that you need just to get started with a job? I think if you ask me, the ability to log in. So no, you basically understand. You understand the seven step basic understanding, right? Login, copy, paste, you know, a little bit of LinkedIn you know, ideas, like what is what, all those things, basic stuff. Let's only just say, you know.
I mean, are we working, I think, for reskilling 101?
Yes, yes.
Does the graduate need to understand all the 7 steps, or we can just go with the last?
No, three? Just understand. He needs to understand it. He doesn't need to master the 7 steps.
Oh, because, you know, I get
your point. Yeah. He needs to just understand logging in, copying, login, copy, paste, you know, messaging, Excel, dashboard, you know, all these things, basic stuff, right? You know, which is like literally, you know, so simple, right? So this is what he needs to do to understand and listen. For delivering, you know, like, you know, enough, I think I would say, meeting with client,
communicating,
creating story, creating video, communicating.
Should we say communicating or engaging?
Communicating. Better is engaging, actually. Yeah. Engaging client. So these are all the things that you need to, you know, to sort of, you know, I mean, there are more, but I'm just trying to show you the difference, you know, between what's the difference between, you know, 101 and 201. And in 301, if you ask me, what is the thing that you can say that you have mastered it, right? I would say in order to master something, I think target audience selection. This is, I would say, is your mastery. You know, the client should go crazy, you know, trying to master, you know, the things. Okay. What else? Course correcting, you know, course correcting bad campaigns. Right.
Bringing them... pitching?
Sorry.
Pitching, winning client.
Yes. That also is there.
Closing the deal.
Yeah, closing the deal. Yeah, closing the deal is also, yeah, it's a mastery. Yeah, agreed. But there is more to this, okay? Because I'm like realizing so much more. And then, for example, here I'm, you know, all kinds of new things have started coming up, guys. You know, the social media research. Yesterday, we won a job for Sheila where we're going to do, an entire, you know, CRM of a very big client in London. We are going to clean it up. Or no, not clean it up. Entire CRM, data validation, and enrichment. So we're going to validate and enrich the entire data in their CRM system. We are also going to do creating event and audience for that event, creating events and audiences for that event. This is very interesting service. So I don't know whether you guys really saw my update to our front page. You know, I have updated some really, you know, in an interesting way. So all these services are right now available. They're quite easy. So that's why I'm not really worried about, you know, teaching you guys yet, you know, because Sheila is going to learn it and all of you will learn along with her. Okay, cool. So that's the thing, the reskilling engine. And we will work on this reskilling engine in 3 ways. The first engine is this one, this learning skills. You know, I can even call it, you know, 101 here, but it's up to you how you want to, call it. But it's reskilling 101, reskilling 201, reskilling 301. Yeah. Just enough to get started. You can finish it in 2 hours. This will take 20 days or 1 month. This will take a lifetime to master. And we will do that. So this is what, we need to do. If you have any feedback on what we can do, you know, don't underestimate the simple thing. In life, sometimes simple things is what is very important. I've had like so many meetings with UNHCR and they just love this simple idea. This one link we send to invite and this one link we send for them to, so that they can go through this thing. There is no password. There is no something to download, right? It's just they are saying this is incredible. Actually, you know, we can you know, make huge progress with this simple you know, things. Okay, so anyway, I don't want to beat the bush again and again, right? So this is okay. Now coming back to our third one, this is a very important thing that I want to discuss. Anything you want to say on the reskilling engine, guys? Anybody who wants to join me in working on this reskilling engine? I'm not sure whether I can appoint somebody for as a leader for the reskilling engine, but I don't mind, you know, people joining me in this engine. Anybody else wants to work with me on building this reskilling engine?
Yes, Anis, I can support as well, if you don't mind.
I mean, of course, I don't mind. I'm just looking for more diverse set of people. Anyone else? It's not difficult, guys, but it needs a little bit of research, you know, like you have to tell me, Anis, we left out this one. We haven't, you know, focused on this one. We forgot that, or, you know, something like that. Or this is too difficult for people to, you know, follow. Shall we rearrange it easily? You know, it's not rocket science, but still it's, you know, it's a bit research, you know, rather than it's there is no work here. It's just making it correct, you know, making it flow like river. It needs to flow. Okay, think about that. Okay, the leader for finding jobs is basically, you know, nothing but the leader for selling and marketing, because there is no other way we are trying to, you know, find jobs. We are finding it through selling or marketing. So I'm not going to have one more leader for, you know, the jobs engine, which is finding jobs. But but I want to discuss something. Okay, very quickly, I'll show you. We discussed about our first message. You remember? I think Mohammed also said something we need to correct, right? You know, just going to revisit that again, okay, quickly. I got enormous feedback on our second message already, okay? I went through a number of people, because sometimes what happens, guys, you know, I am so close to this, right? My mind is completely, you know, corrupted as in, you know, my mind is filled with preconceived ideas, okay? So I'm not the best person to review, you know, our work, or my, you can say my own work, okay? So what I have done is I have, you know, I reviewed this with a number of people. I have come out with a changed, you know, second message. Because our previous second message, you want to see the previous second message? Everybody is saying, you know, is quite quite big. You understand? It's like too big. You know, let me just show you okay. So this was our first message. Okay, this is a slightly modified first message. Second. Even this is basically a very different second message that I'm using, but the feedback that I got was, do not try to sell in the second message. You know, do not try to blatantly say social media is important, buy it from us. So what they're saying is, okay, please, guys, I really need you to talk to me, okay? So when we send the first message, it's very good. Each of us have a role to play in responding to the refugee crisis. We are doing this. It's amazing. It's perfect, right? Now, this is a very high ground. You know, we have taken a very high ground, you know. Please, let's do something, you know. And then immediately, we take a low ground. So buy this social media selling from us. You understand the point? So many people that I reviewed the first message and second message, you know, told me that I need to completely change my second message, completely. You know, the message that I was so, I must have spent, I don't know, 20, 30 hours on that message. But I'm getting a feedback to change that completely. Just I want to pause here and, you know, listen to all of you guys. What should we do? Let me show, I mean, I don't know whether I have the second message because I've already changed it. But let me, it must be there somewhere. And I really need some, people to discuss this with me. Yeah? You're not going to keep quiet. You have to tell me, what do you think? So what do we do? People are saying, do not pitch. You started so high and immediately you're becoming a salesperson. People just switch off. So look at this second message, right? Many thanks for connecting. We believe social media is changing the way we do stuff. So, you know, immediately we pitch, and then ask them to give us a job. And the second thing is, when we try to do this, look at the size of the thing. Okay. Yeah, Bahan, I'm just going to, let me, you know, get Joel. What happened to Joel? So when I send a message, the second message especially, just look at how it's going to look, you know, when I send this. Okay. So this is on my large screen. When this goes on, let's say a small screen of somebody, it will take them like a few minutes to scroll down this whole message. It is that big. And then we are talking about an initial meeting. If you like it, choose. He's saying, you know, from a very lofty ground, you have just fallen down to a sales guy. Any comments, guys, on this? They're saying, you know, don't do this. Do not change this. Instead of, you know, talking about social media, how we can help, et cetera, make all those things, you know, anyway, they're saying, you know, all of those ideas, details, everything is there in your deck. They're saying somehow make sure that you send the deck with your second message and make sure that they are able to see the second, the deck. That should be your, ultimate idea. And therefore, I have come up with this second message. Have a look at this. This is the second message. So it goes like this. Many thanks for connecting. I keep my high ground. We believe access to education and opportunities is a fundamental human right, yet 80 million refugees do not have these rights. So we keep the high ground. Then we say, over the last 3 years, we have reskilled and employed over 250 refugees from UNHCR refugee camps. Our vision is to reskill and employ 1 million refugees in one marketable skill over the next 10 years. So this is our vision. So still we are, you know, maintaining the high ground. Okay. Here is our story so far, which is the deck. Okay. I'm not sending the video here because the video has already been sent. Okay. So I'm not going to send. This is the link to the deck. Then simply ask, will you join us in this human revolution where the global community comes together to address the refugee crisis in the most dignified way? I have stepped up. Will you? Your name. So this one is almost half the size as what we had here. Almost half. Not entirely, but look at this. So it's one sentence, second sentence, third sentence, signature. So three sentences, signature, and one sentence has the thing. And it also beautifully appears as a story of StepUp.1 so far.
What's our prediction in terms of engagement? What do we expect? Like, how would a client respond to such message as, like?
Good point. So basically you're saying, you know, why you're not having a call to action in the message itself, right? So I have stepped up with you. What we want is, you know, so basically what I'm saying is let the client look at this. I mean, the deck that we are sharing, and the last, you know, we are sharing all these, you know, things, because basically what they're saying is this deck is our powerful weapon. Okay. So they're saying, you know, let people look at the deck. And then in the last, look at this. What can you do from now? You can hire us to make your, because I've explained everything here, you know, like what are we doing, et cetera, et cetera. But these are the three call to actions. Hire us, be a mentor, you know, lend us your shoulder so that we can stand on it, or give us your platform so that we can work together. So these are the three call to actions, Bhana. But these three call to actions are inside the deck.
That's clear.
But I am also, you know, very, very, I am desperately want to bring these three call to action to the message itself. Desperately. Because I am not sure how many people will open the thing.
Yeah, I think that's my worry as well. But can we, let's say, for example, you know, once you've shared the second message with a potential client, can we agree on a timeline? Like when can we maybe send a follow-up, a very, you know, a short follow-up message? So, you know, maybe the person has not gotten the chance to open our deck and has not gotten back to us, because since in our second message there's no call to action, then it's very difficult to like to tell whether they have actually learned who we are really or not. Is there a way we could maybe follow up with them after a certain time, you know, sometimes? And
Yes, I have that step, but I'm not convinced, you know. You see, that one is such a small message. I'll show you my third message. I have made it into such a small follow-up that, you know, it feels like there is really nothing. Because the last thing I want to do is to, you know, pain people with so many messages, right? So look at this. That's it. Third message is that's it. I hope you had a chance to see how far we have come. And then a video. And then maybe you can add one more sentence. But honestly, we shouldn't really, you know.
Then with this new approach, what happens if somebody asks you? Because there are those actually who don't take the luxury to read all these things. He just throw you his email address and tells you, you know, send me more information or a proposal on this to my email. What do we send to such
the email thing is really good. You know, I have no problem, because the moment you go to email, it's the big story we have.
Great.
The normal one that you guys send, you know, I'm okay with that.
Okay.
Okay. The email is okay, because the email is like long, you know, hope you're in the best of your spirits. You know, here is some background, you know, here is how I got inspired. Here is a list, you know, it's okay. I think, you know, we can do the email. But what the advice that people are telling is like, keep the LinkedIn one as short as possible. I just want to pick your brain one more time. Maybe, you know, Joel, Muhammad, Keisha, Shem, you know, or anybody else, you know, can you, you know, once again, just have a look at the second message. Okay. Because if there is something that is, you know, repeating here, this second message, we can remove it, because they're saying just keep the second message as short as possible and make sure it doesn't smell like you are trying to sell something. or do you want to bring the three things? Will you join us something and then maybe, you know, say, here are the three ways you can do it. Just bring it over here.
Yeah, I think from the way you've just explained it, we can keep it as it is now, and then maybe we try it out for a few months and see how it works. Because for me, it's pretty much straightforward. Mm. And if they'll have access to the deck, and then, because again, if you bring in those three call to actions again, so we go back again to selling in the second message. Because we are prompting them to do each and each. Mm.
Okay, let's try this. I think it took me a lot of convincing to remove my second message, the very, very passionately created second message, because I felt, it had the meat. We still need the content of the second message, the old second message, because that is what we need to send if somebody says, okay, how can I help you? You understand? For example, you send the first message, okay, and somebody says, how can I help you? Then you should never send this second message, correct? Never. Okay, second message, when there is no question or reaction from the client after. Okay, so this is what you're going to send when there is no question or reaction from the client, okay? But second message, if there is a question or some reaction from the client, okay, then what do? You answer the question in the very first line directly, okay? Then you can actually put the second message, so the original second message. You with me, guys? Are you with me? You are able to understand what I'm trying to do here? Okay. You answer the question directly. Then you say, we believe social media is changing the way. Then you say, with social selling, we do this. With social marketing, we do this. Here is how it works. Or we can even, I can give you more. You can say this thing. There are three ways in which you can join hands with us. And then you say, this one, hire us. Second, lend us your voice. Third, give us your platform. Okay. So this is something that you can say. Then you can basically say, we believe social media. I think that you can say this, right? With social media, here is how it works. This you have already said, so you don't have to say this. No, this is also too cheesy. I don't think you need to say this. You can hire graduates from this link. Or I don't know, we can ask them to book a meeting or I don't know. Huh? This could be another second message. What do you guys think, So if there is no response, we send this. We still, keep a high ground. We don't look like a salesperson trying to sell some social media, some idea. But if they say, okay, tell me what should I, how can I help? What should I do? What would you need from me? Then we can say this. You guys okay with that? Is that making sense?
Oh. Hi, Anish.
Yes, Patience.
Yeah, I think it's good just to bring another second message because, you know, I've realized that most of our clients, potential clients, once we send the first message, they always say we are interested, you know, what can we help? But once we send the second message, they keep quiet. They don't say anything. Yeah, I think it is good.
Yeah, because you know, yeah, we want to basically, you know, we want our clients to click on this link. That's it. Okay. We want every one of our clients to, if people, the chances of me getting a job is so high if people see this deck. So we have to make them see this deck somehow. We have, in the previous approach, you know, we have waited for third message, you know, that's too far. And by the time those guys have switched off, because, you know, we have tried to sell something very desperately. So I think let's try this approach. But if somebody asks very point blank how they can help, we can basically say this, and then, you know, and then take it from there. That's what I think. I think, you know, we should.
Yes, Kitty. Okay, what about the third message?
Yeah, the third message I just showed you, right? It's quite simple. You know, if you still don't get any response, you just simply say, I hope you had a chance to review our deck. You know, that's it. Just waiting for your response. Something, just one small sentence. That's it. It's already changed and it's already here. I hope you had a chance to, you know, review our deck. That's it. That's it. Just one sentence. Because the more we say, the more we, you know, sound like a sales guy. Yes. Yes. Espoir. SP. Yes, do you want to ask something, SP? So this is the third message. Okay. So so that's pretty much, you know, what I had in mind to discuss today, which is, you know, explain to you our, you know, thing, strategy for, you know, changing the second message and third message. And also look at, you know, appointing leaders for each of these things. Okay, let me quickly, you know, just look at that thing. Step up.1, weekly actions. Yeah, so this is what, I also want to, just one small reminder, we'll try to cover this maybe next week. Whenever you have a meeting with a client, please send a meeting minutes after the meeting. Okay, it's really important, and I have just created one, you know, which you can follow. Especially, you know, more the meeting where the client says, "Okay, let's start." Okay, so here are the key actions. Please, could you visit this page and sign up? You know, Keisha. So this particular meeting was after we signed up for Keisha for something. So. You know, step one is for the client. Please do this step. Step two is for the client. Please, could you share your, URL, this thing, credentials. Step three, can you draft the storyline that needs to be converted into a video? We already got started on this. Step four, draft the first message that needs to be connection. Step five, finalize the target audience by country and do it. So this is like a sample minutes of the meeting. When we close the meeting with the client, and you know, I want each one of you to be able to, you know, write a similar kind of a thing after your meeting with the client gets over, so that, you know, immediately your job is quickly, you know, closed. I think it is an important step for closing the job. I found that, none of you, you know, were having this practice. Whenever you have a meeting, minute the meeting and send a minutes of the meeting to the client. We reviewed our four engines. Again, you know, our four engines are onboarding, reskilling, finding the jobs, and working for clients. I think we did reskilling today and finding jobs. Finding jobs is what we need to, you know, make better and better. Next week, we'll, you know, look at, again, finding jobs. We'll look at it because it's never-ending job. And the working for clients also, we'll try to, you know, look at next week. And of course, the reskilling is also very important. We'll look at it next week. Any last questions or comments before we close this call today? SP, I thought you wanted to say something. I don't know. You still want to say something?
Yes. So I would like just to know, once you send the first message to a client, then I tell you that he's not interested in social media, but he can link you. Are you supposed to send a second message or not?
Yeah, just first answer his question, because he has asked you something, right? You can basically say, we do a lot of work, not just social media. In fact, we can, you know, get a nice message for that. So we do, other than, we can even start like this. Our core services are social media marketing and social media selling. However, we do work on a number of other things for our clients, such as, you know, doing research, gathering data, you know, creating lists, creating events, you know, gathering audience, you know, data enrichment in CRM systems, data entry in CRM systems. I think we can basically write a nice 10, 15 such services. All of that under the heading social media research. Okay. So that, you know, we don't really leave anything out on the table. Kasi, you are the one who asked, or SP asked this question? SP, yeah.
So that was my question, and I'm really satisfied with that.
Yeah, but always answer the question first, SP. Always answer the question first. Then send the second message, you know, whatever, you know, like which second message, you know, this second message, you know, the one where we are saying, you know, you can do three things. Always be relevant to the question that they are asking, you know. Do not try to send something just because you like it, you know. Yes, Kasi. Kasi, we can't hear you if you're talking.
He asked you, but at the end of the day, he finds you've answered him with the second message that is not in line with the question that he asked. That he asked you. So I was feeling like that might be also part of the things that are making us to not like win, or these people to hire us, because, like, when they see the answer that you've given him is not like related to the question, he feels, then he leaves that goes that way. He doesn't reply again. He doesn't tell you what's next and so on. But now, like, if we can be like the way you've explained it today to us, that we can first answer the question, then later on we accompany it with the second message. That is much better, and it's good that all of us, we understand that it's good when a client asks a question, we are ready to answer the question first, then we go to the second message. I'm really happy that is addressed today. Thank you.
Yes, Kasi, and then, you know, not only that, right? Don't feel compelled to write the whole thing, okay? So, for example...
The Bluetooth device is...
So you can, edit the second message, okay? So you can answer the question first, okay? You answer the question, and then the guy says, I'm not interested in social media at all. So immediately say, I know you're not interested in our first service, but here is the three that we do. You understand? So you have already said, you know that he's not interested in the first service. Right? So, yeah, so that's what we need to do. Okay. All right. Any other questions? Yeah, Shem. Shem, we're not able to hear you.
Yeah. Suggesting the not a message. Oh yeah. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, I was suggesting that now that you have the first, the second message edited, and we've got social selling and social media marketing. What about the third, service that we have that we offer at Step Up? I think it could also be okay if we include it in the second message, so that once we send the second message to our clients, he will understand all our three services that we offer at Step Up.
Yes. Not sure I understood Shem's questions very clearly, but yes, we have to articulate the three things that we are doing, very precisely in our second message, which is what we are trying to do.
Okay.
We can still modify the second message, and make it even more longer, and allow you to edit the second message, based on what the client is asking, so that you can edit and chop, some messages and leave the remaining, for them. Okay. Let's do that. One quick news, Shem has been successful in convincing a professor from Netherlands to be his mentor. So Marianne has accepted to be the country leader for Netherlands, and Shem has started sending messages, finding job messages on behalf of Marianne to all the top people in Netherlands. And that's a huge congratulations to Shem. We also, I don't see, Jean-Marie in today's call. I don't know whether he was there and dropped off. But Jean-Marie is doing the same thing for StepUp.1 Canada, and Shem is doing that for StepUp.1 Netherlands. So we have two countries where we have two volunteers who's shared their LinkedIn credentials with Shem and Jean-Marie, and they both are working, and they've just started this. So hopefully this is such an important thing that we are doing. And I really want all of you to be on the lookout for volunteers in either Europe or in the US who can help us, give their shoulders so that we can stand on top of them.
Sorry, Anis, on that note, I have a question. As we are looking for volunteers, do we have already a drafted message that we can send to people, potential people who we think we can identify as volunteers?
Yeah, I can try to give it a shot. I can definitely try to give it a shot. I do not have, a precise message, but maybe, I don't know, Shem or Jean-Marie can help. With both the cases, we set up a meeting, we talk to the volunteer, we convince them, and then they agree to be our volunteer. But nobody will agree to do this without, a meeting. But it's a good idea to, come up with a message. Can you take a shot, Joel? Is it hard for you? Basically, it's very simple, right? It's like, there is actually a huge benefit for being a volunteer also. So the volunteer gets connected with all the top people in their country. If the volunteer tried to connect with the top people in their country by themselves, nobody will connect.
Yeah. I don't know if I'll try, but I'm not sure if I'll come up with something useful.
It just needs to be just, you know, similar to this, you know, the first message and second message, you know, it's a mixture of all those things. See, even to a volunteer, the first message is the same. Okay? Only the second message has to be different. But yeah, let's try that, Joel. You know, you and me will work on a message format, you know, for volunteers.
Yeah, sure. I think we can, because at some point we might have people in our mind, but you know, the first approach will be like maybe sending a message, requesting for the meeting, and now have that meeting, you know. That's why it's really important to have that message, I think, on my opinion.
Because I think it is we don't know how it's going to work, but the more credible that person, the easier it is for us to land a job.
Yeah, sure.
Any other thoughts? Shall we call it a day? I think we should call it a day. It's already 12:10. All right, everybody. Thank you very much. We shall see you all next week, I hope. And until then, bye-bye.
Bye.